Hello and welcome to the JB&M Sports Fanatic channel. Thank you for joining me for this video. And the Arizona Cardinals are signing another receiver to add more depth or perhaps just to compete throughout camp. And that's receiver Antoine Wesley. Now, the interesting thing about Antoine Wesley, and this article does cover that, is that he does have some familiarity with Cliff Kingsbury going back to their time together at Texas Tech. And that was prior to Antoine Wesley when he first entered the league and spent his first 2 years in the NFL with the Baltimore Ravens. So now he has a one-year contract with the Cardinals. And the Cardinals, they had two open roster spots. And so it made sense to bring him in. I mean, Wesley, he was undrafted in 2019 and prior to signing with the Ravens when he came out of Texas Tech. And so he spent that season on the practice squad and then spent 2020 on IR with a bad shoulder. And so even going back, honestly, to college, I believe he was injured as well, going back to 2018. Going back to 2018, coming off of serious labrum injury, in which when he wasn't hurt, he did a pretty good job in Kingsbury's offense. But obviously injuries has derailed most of his opportunities thus far. But he's got the talent, which is why he's still in the NFL right now, looking to, you know, take advantage of an opportunity and just really be healthy. And so that's the first step, being healthy, being available, and then being able to get those reps and continue to improve. And so it does help to have a coach in which you obviously knows what you can do from college. So that does help you get this opportunity. But, you know, it's going to be up to him to maintain, you know, spot. There's a lot of competition. I mean, we're talking about a whole lot of receivers. And this article goes into listing some of the receivers. Obviously, we don't know still for sure what Larry Fitzgerald is going to do, whether or not he's going to come back, retire, all of that stuff. But what we do know is that they do have DeAndre Hopkins. Obviously, they did pick up AJ Green. They still got Christian Kirk, you know, Randall Moore, and then guys like, you know, Andy Isabella, Keyshawn Johnson, AJ Richardson, Rico Gofford, Krishan Hogan, JoJo Ward, Andre Basilia, and Isaac Whitney. There's a lot of receivers already. And so the Cardinals are making sure they're doing their due diligence. And then on top of that, you've got DeAndre Hopkins tweeting about, you know, the possibility of trying to convince, well, and people inquiring about him trying to persuade, I should say, the receiver Julio Jones for the Falcons to potentially end up with the Cardinals as well. So can you imagine that if they end up getting him as well? I mean, this receiver room is already crowded. I mean, and if that were to happen and then Larry Fitzgerald decides that he wants to come back again, even though obviously at this point he's not the same guy that he was when he was in his prime, nowhere near that. But I mean, to still have, you know, just him as a, you know, like fourth, fifth option at times, you know, like, or just his veteran presence on top of actually having guys like Hopkins, if AJ Green is remotely, you know, healthy and can look something like what we've seen in the past, doesn't have to be prime AJ Green, just something close to it. And then you add Julio Jones to that. Come on, Kyler Murray, that would be a lock to win the MVP this upcoming year, which I'm projecting that he's going to have a fantastic year this upcoming season. And so the only difficulty for the Cardinals, I feel, well, the biggest difficulty, I should say, is their division. It's just so good from top to bottom. Every team in that division has a chance. Every team in that division legitimately knows that they can contend with the best teams in the league, not just division. So this is going to be a tough division. But with that being said, though, to get back on topic here, Antoine Wesley, he's definitely has that connection going for him. And he's tall. He's about 6'4", 6'5". And so throughout his time at the collegiate level, just to high cap some of the production that he's been able to kindle together with Kingsbury, obviously in 2016 as a freshman, he didn't really get to play at all that season. But 2017 was when he really first got to contribute to the team. And he had 10 receptions for 137 yards, averaging 13.7 yards a catch that season. But he really took off in 2018, his last year at Texas Tech as a junior, where in 12 games, he had 88 receptions for 1,410 yards, averaging 16 yards a catch and 9 receiving touchdowns. So definitely that season right there is the one that Kingsbury definitely is hoping for, that he's able to accumulate with the Cardinals in his office. And I believe that was the last time that Kingsbury was at Texas Tech prior to getting the Arizona Cardinals head coaching job. So yeah, definitely he has a firm understanding of this guy's ability, what he can be. And sometimes it's about being in the right place at the right time, the right opportunity. So this seems like the right place. I just question the timing of it because they've got a lot of receivers here. And who knows if you know, there's any, truth or any hope for, Julio Jones, although I do not think that he's going to end up with the Cardinals. You know, there's a lot of other rumors as well about where he can end up at, but that's a whole different video there. But if that were to happen, that'd be just ridiculous and crazy. I mean, everybody everywhere is going to want to play with the Cardinals on Madden if that happens. So, but certainly understand, for the coach doing his due diligence and bringing in a guy in which he knows has the talent. It's just a matter of him getting an opportunity, perhaps, making the practice squad and going from there. But we'll see how everything plays out. Obviously, Cardinals are going to have to trim down some receivers at some point. So we'll see how that works out. But for now, this is great for Cardinal fans because you're going to end up with the best of the best. So, and that's what you want as a fan. So with that being said, thank you so much for joining me for this video. Hope you enjoyed it. And as always, as more news continues to drop, you can be sure to find it here. So thanks again for watching and see you guys next time.